this time we'd like to introduce you to those competing for the Holstein Futurity competition. Entry 3471, Arethusa Goldwyn Valerie, exhibited by Arethusa Farm of Litchfield, Connecticut. 3472, Arethusa Jasper Velour, exhibited by Arethusa Farm, Litchfield, Connecticut. Entry 3473, Hardy's Talent Danica, exhibited by Parker Hardy of Tipton, Michigan. Entry 3474, Linville Aspen Primrose, exhibited by William Schultz III of Waldo, Wisconsin. Entry 3475, Seamers Goldwyn Glams, exhibited by the Seamers family of Newton, Wisconsin. Entry 3476, Kingsway Goldwyn Ashbury, exhibited by Mike Deaver of Edgerton, Wisconsin. Entry 3477, Emerald Acre VR Flirton, exhibited by Becky Hammond of Barron, Wisconsin. Entry 3478, Seamers Goldwyn Goldie, exhibited by Jordan and Whitney Ebert of Algoma, Wisconsin. 3479, Filmardo Jolie Jasper, exhibited by Kyle Natsky and Kaylee and Callista Hodorf of Fond du Lac, Wisconsin. Entry 3480, Ms. Crescent Mead Gold Aqua, exhibited by Jordan and Whitney Ebert of Algoma, Wisconsin. And our final entry is entry 3481, Lake Prairie Kite Annika, exhibited by Joseph, Zach, Jerome, and Darian Stransky of Owatonna, Minnesota. Ladies and gentlemen, placings are complete in the Holstein Futurity Competition. Placing third in the class is entry 3475, Seamers Goldwyn Glams, exhibited by the Seamers family of Newton, Wisconsin. Second in the class is entry 3481, Lake Prairie Kite Annika, exhibited by Joseph, Zach, Jerome, and Darian Stransky of Owatonna, Minnesota. And the winning entry, best udder and first bred and known, entry 3472, Arethusa Jasper Velour, exhibited by Arethusa Farm of Litchfield, Connecticut. Congratulations. Judge your comments.
Two exceptional cows here at the top of the Futurity, a junior three and a senior three. I think this junior three overwhelms the cow in second, and they're both exceptionally good cows, but this junior three, she's a load. I mean, she's got an incredible frame. The cow's got that big, long, open rib that I like to see. She's extremely long-bodied, long in all her parts, massive along with that. She's got that long, pretty four-udder. Today, she just has the length of four-udder today over the cow in second. And just, like I said, overwhelms her in her frame, her hardness atop, her levelness from hooks to pins over the second cow. Second cow easily in second. More closely follows the first cow in her squareness of cut and her balance all the way through, her depth of body, spring of rib, overall massiveness and dairiness and quality over the cow coming in third. The third cow over the fourth cow, she types in as well to the first two cows. This third cow has more chine in front end, width through that chest, power all the way through. And just the udder's a little higher above the hocks and a little snugger all the way through than the real stylish dairy quality cow in fourth. The fourth cow over the fifth cow, she just has more balance on her top line today. Cow has more chest and fore rib and more width through that muzzle, just more power all the way through than a really fine uddered cow coming out here in fifth. Congratulations on a really nice Futurity, an exceptional top pair. Thank you.